So is being a social media influencer for you? Shayna says you better be ready to be on close to 24/7, and a backup plan might be a good idea.
The palettes, the products, the process.
I've always been passionate about makeup.
So it was no surprise that Sarah Lapierre was captivated by online makeup tutorials.
And I thought it was really cool that I could watch a 10-minute video and learn so much. I kind of just thought to myself, I feel like I could do this.
So just do one pump of that.
Inspired, Lapierre launched her own YouTube channel and Instagram account 2 years ago, becoming a beauty influencer.
I like to call it a passion project.
But the price of that passion?
It's very time consuming. It's a huge undertaking. I work at it all the time and every single day.
Well, I am so excited.
Lapierre communicates back and forth with beauty brands to build her business, samples products, shoots and edits her videos, all while focusing her attention on her day job in marketing.
It's definitely tough to find the drive all the time to really put in the work.
Constantly posting fresh content and responding to her followers' questions takes time, says Lapierre.
The most important thing is to be authentic. I try and put my own personality into everything I post and that I put out there so that people can really get to know me.
Putting my robe back on.
Lapierre says she keeps her followers interested by posting about her personal life.
Initially, I kept my personal Instagram separate, and I realized it didn't really make sense. I wasn't letting people into my real life that way. So I really probably started posting about my life once I got engaged. So I got to share all of that personal content, and I think people really liked that, and I realized that people like actually care about my life.
Brianne Johansson is a wife, a mom, a marketer, and is a home decor and fashion influencer where she shares her busy world with her Instagram following.
I will spend hours brightening stuff or removing lines and editing pictures.
As Johansson's creative juices flow, time flies.
I love the editing process and even writing fun status copy, for instance, but it can really take hours and all this stuff adds up. It takes a lot more time than you think.
And time is not always on Johansson's side.
I turn down a lot of stuff too because I just don't want to take the time away from my family.
And there's another necessity. Influencers must comply with the FTC.
The FTC has really cracked down, and if there is any type of trade or paid transaction, you have to disclose in your caption that this is sponsored. Now these influencers are held accountable.
One celebrity comes to mind is Kim Kardashian. She has gotten into major trouble. She promoted some prenatal vitamins and never disclosed the relationship.
So would you want to be an influencer?
My advice is to not be a full-time influencer. I also own a PR and marketing and social media agency, and I always feel like you should have a backup plan. While I love being an influencer and sharing, who knows, Instagram could, you know, close tomorrow.
Despite the challenges and market saturation, new influencers are popping up every day.
It has just exploded, and more people are having a voice online. I don't see it going anywhere anytime soon, especially with all the great content that's being created. It's a peek into somebody else's world.
$2 billion was reportedly spent on influencer marketing last year. Studies predict that could grow to $10 billion in the next 5 years. That's it for Chronicle for tonight. Remember, follow us on Instagram and Twitter.